Okay. All right, do we have anybody on? If you're on, if you can let me know if you can see me, hear me. Let's see. All right. Okay, we've got some people on. We're a couple minutes late today. I'm having technical difficulties, so I apologize for that. Okay. So, because we are a couple minutes behind, and I do know that this is being recorded, I'm going to go ahead and start because plenty of people can watch this after. So, my name is Noelle Poe, and I'm with Girl Scouts Kentucky's Wilderness Road. Let me get my camera fixed here. And we are doing virtual programs as much as we can throughout the week. My name is, or I said my name, I'm the manager for membership and program with our council. I am Sarah Lewis is my counterpart and has been doing several of these videos. You are going to start seeing more people soon. Tomorrow we've got a Camp Songs video for you. Next week we are going to be going live one day next week on Instagram and doing an interview with Donate Life Kentucky. We're going to be talking with Stephanie Grooms with Donate Life about the Girls Donate Life Patch. April is Donate Life Month, and we really want to highlight some of the cool things that's going on. Don't forget to check the chat log while we're on here because you will see links that get posted. And we want to know where you're from. Where are you tuning in from? Where are you watching this from today? And what level are you? Let us know. Are you, that's going to really help me kind of figure out how I'm going to give the best information session today, is if I know what level, if you're a leader, what level are you teaching? If you're a girl, what are you doing? So, to give a little bit of a background on this, we have a partnership with Fidelity, and they were amazing enough to create a curriculum for us and a patch curriculum that allows daisies through ambassadors to learn about investing in their future and letting it grow. So it's an investment patch. I've got a picture here. You can kind of see what the patches look like. So you get the top patch and then each additional bar. The first three are Daisy Brownie Jr., the last three are Cadet Senior Ambassador. However, every girl, every level can earn all six of them. And we want to encourage you. You're just gonna have to change a little bit about what you do. For our ambassadors that are earning the thinking about your future, which is that first patch. You're gonna maybe wanna change things up because it's gonna be a bit simple. So I'm gonna walk through. I see that we've got some daisies on here. We've got some seniors, cadets and seniors. So I'm gonna walk through each of these levels, each of the patches, starting from the first one, and just tell you what the steps are and give you a little idea about how you might be able to do these from home now, or with your troop virtually. So the thinking about my future is the first patch, and the step, there's three steps. Think about you in the past, present, and future. Wait for something special in the future. Think about what you would like when you are older. So some of the steps for those. So daisies, there's three options under each of these steps in the curriculum, and daisies choose one of those, brownies choose two of those options, and juniors will do all three. So as an example of that, For step one thing you can do, think about you in the past, present, and future, is you can create a souvenir. So, souvenir is French for the word remember. And if you have a souvenir, maybe you've gone to a World Thinking Day event, or maybe you have a swap from someone. A swap alone is almost a souvenir. But how can you create a souvenir out of a Girl Scout event you've done? For step three, one of my favorite is let's see, it's or step two, wait for something special in the future. And that is maybe help a seed grow. It is the perfect time right now to get seeds started. You can get the seeds started in your home and move them outside. I actually have a, I was able to order just a bunch of seeds online. These are herbs that I was able to get from the True Leaf Market. And it's just a bunch of seeds that I can go ahead and start in my home in a small pot. Nothing, not too much bigger, maybe even smaller than that, before it's warm enough to move them outside. So that's the first one, and that is the thinking about my future patch for Daisies, Brownies, Juniors. Remember, Cadet, Seniors, Ambassadors, you can do that one as well. The second one, investing in others. Now, investing in others is big right now. We are doing a lot of this and helping others. So save. What do you need to save to help money, if that's financially, to save to help others? Learn how the government is helping others. How is the government helping others right now? What's being donated? What decisions are they making to make sure that they're helping others? And then advocate for others' future. Helping other people learn what they're going to do. So an example of that, same as the first one, Daisies will choose one activity, Brownies will choose two, and Juniors will do all three. And for step one, volunteer your time. Now, volunteering your time, we sometimes think that means we need to leave our home and go out and do something. But right now, a lot of people are at home making face masks. The personal protective equipment, the PPEs that people need. So, what time can you put into your day to take some of those steps? What are some things, and let me know in the chat log, what are some things that you've already done where you're investing your time to help others while we are all staying healthy at home? Let's see. And another step, and this would be great, advocating for another's future. So one of the steps is share a story. Telling the story about future goals of an organization that helps others give story a bigger voice. Use your voice to spread the goals of an organization through a story, video, or artwork. Share your creation with others. So what can maybe we share some stories about Girl Scouts? What are we doing now and what can we do to help and support our organization? Right now, we've got an amazing cookie relief program where corporations are helping out. And I'm actually going to highlight that because that is one of the steps for one of the Cadet Senior Ambassador patches. So the next patch, investing in business. Learn how employees are paid for their work. Learn how governments and businesses work together. And discover how to invest in business. One of the examples of this in step two, discover the benefits of being a good corporate citizen. So, what are some of our big organizations doing right now that are helping others? I saw a news article that Home Depot is donating a bunch of face masks. We have organizations, we have corporations who are buying cookies to donate. To donate to the hospitals, to donate to first responders. So those are really good examples. What others can you find? Same applies as before. Daisies are in one, brownies do two steps, and juniors do the three steps. And you can download these online. The link is in the event page. And you'll see that the steps are in this format. So you've got step one, and then the three options below. You can find these and choose how you want to earn these patches, and then I'll show you how to order them in just a minute. We have people commenting. Some people are making cards to send to the elderly in their church. That is an amazing way. A lot of retirement communities, assisted living homes are closed to the public, and I know my grandma lives in one, and I'm not able to go visit her and see her in person right now, but sending cards and letting them know. That's a great idea. I love that you all are doing that. So on to the next patch, and please, if you have any questions, type those in the chat log because I'm watching that and would be happy to answer any questions you might have. So the next one is investing in home and cadet seniors ambassadors. This is big for you, especially as you're getting ready to think about like, what am I going to do after high school or college or when I get older? So this has more steps. And the cadets choose one activity, seniors and ambassadors choose two or three activities under each step. So step for investing in home patch, explore how different features and houses affect the price. See how home improvements can increase a home's value. Examine how location affects housing costs. Learn how investment in a home appreciates over time. Evaluate the opportunity cost of investing in a home. And you might need an adult to help answer some of these questions. And we hope that when we can all be in the same place together, that we'll be able to have employees at Fidelity be involved and help some of our troops earn this process, because they definitely want to volunteer some of their time and help us earn these patches. But right now we're all being healthy at home. So one of the things that you can do earn this patch that I think could be really exciting for you, and I actually did this today, is spruce up your room. So one of the step two, see how home improvements can increase a home's value. One of the options, spruce up your room. Invest in your room by making a small improvement that makes the room a better place to live. Work with an adult to create a plan that fits your home and this your style. What are your favorite colors? What do you feel like you could add in? Do you need to create a space in your home? Maybe it's not in your bedroom. Maybe it's somewhere in your home where you need to focus on your classwork right now. I had to get a desk for my home, and I got a lamp and I got some flowers to put on it, something to organize. I had to create and kind of spruce up my living space so that I can work from home and focus. Maybe that's something you might want to do, or maybe you want to make your room a little bit cozier. So what can you do? Remember to order online or pick up at stores, and you don't need to go in and go shopping right now. And then I'll pause. I'm going to pause for just a minute because I do have people that have said some stuff that they're doing for others. One of the patches was investing in others. So we've got people who are making masks, who are leaving essential items on doorsteps, so like delivery workers. And then we've got some people who are kind of figuring out they're learning with their family how to make money and pay bills. I've seen one of our teachers, I live in Newport, and one of the teachers here in Newport, she put a cost on the snacks that are in their pantry. So that, because her kids are home all day, when they're going and they grab a bag of chips and they go and they grab a snack, how much money is that? You know, that she's not making them pay for it, but she's making them think about, this is how much my mom is spending while we're home. And am I really hungry right now? Do I really need to spend this money or do that a little bit later? So then that was the investing. I'm going to do the investing in college is the next one. And again, there's five steps total. Cadets choose one. Seniors and ambassadors can choose two or three. So investing in college is very important. And this also includes work study. This is technical or career colleges. It doesn't have to be just a 4-year, but this is continuing education. So research the financial impact of a post-secondary education. And that's what you're going to do after high school. Compare tuitions at different educational institutions. What's the cost of UK versus Northern Kentucky? Or what is Berea? Berea is a really good college to look at. What does Berea do for their students? And how is that different from a larger university or maybe something even smaller like Center College? And the third step is evaluate the opportunity cost of attaining additional education. So when you're investing in this, what are you going to get out of it? Research ways to fund advanced education. So if you're going to fund not only your post-secondary education, but if you want to become a doctor, you're going to need even more education after that. So what does it look like to fund that? And then examine the savings plan for future educational expenses. Some of these options are looking at what your state, so step five, examine a savings plan for future educational. Emily said, don't forget to check out Morehead State. Of course, because she went to Morehead State. Learn about your state's educational saving fund. What does Kentucky have in place for students to go to school? How does a college saving plan work? Do you have one started? Are you going to start one? And examine the difference between a college savings plan and a regular savings account. What's there? Hi, Helen, Brennan. Nice to see you in the chats. So that is the investing in college patch. And then the last patch you can get is investing in retirement. Now, Cadet Seniors Ambassadors, I am sure you are not already thinking about retirement, but I bet you someone in your life is, and so you can learn a little bit from them and what their thoughts are. So again, five steps, cadets earn one, seniors and ambassadors, you choose two or three of these. So learn more about bonds and how they are used in investing. Sounds like I need to learn some of these as well. Two, research stocks and investing strategies using equities. Understand the risks of investing. Explore how funds invest and their long-term returns. And explore options for investing in your long-term future. So there's a couple things you can do right now. You can look at what does the market look like right now. Learn what a bond is in the first place. Let's see. Research, what is an index fund? Research what that is. Take a quiz about your financial risk tolerance. It says every investor has a different level of tolerance for how much money she is willing to lose in exchange for how much money she might gain. You can visit Fidelity's investment website to take a free risk tolerance quiz and see what your investment risk tolerance level is. And earlier when we talked about investing in college, a comment just came up. Keys Money, K-E-E-S, Keys Money in Kentucky is great for looking at in terms of funding for education. Thank you, Deb, for that. And then you can interview a financial advisor. So we can reach out to Fidelity, see what they think. And we'll definitely be in touch more about this because our hope is to do some live programs with people who are pros at investment and financial literacy. But we already know that you're cookie pros. You all are great at the cookie program. So let me tell you a little bit about how to get the patch. Okay, so you've gone through all these steps and you're like, yes, I've done it. Now I'm ready to get a patch. I want to put it on my uniform. What are you going to do? So keep in mind that things have been on back order for a while because China was dealing with the coronavirus and a lot of their factories shut down. And we do want to keep in mind that shipping's a little bit slower as well in the U.S. But we are working with the Girl Scouts of Green and White Mountains for this, and they're helping. So they initially partnered with Fidelity, helped build this curriculum, and were able to order the patches. So the order form is online, and again, that link is in the event. I know I've got some staff that are watching live right now. If one of you can put that the Girl Scout Patch Program's link on there, you scroll down and find the Fidelity Let It Grow investment patch. So you're gonna see an order form that looks like this, and you'll just put your information, how many you want. There is a fee to ship, and that's on here. So $5 for 25 pieces, $7.50 for 26 to 50. And if you need to order 51 or more, there's a phone number on here for you to call customer service to ask them about that. And then you're just gonna scan and email this order in, and it's advancement@girlscoutsgwmgreenandwhitemountains.org. But most importantly, when you do this, we want you to take the survey that's on the back. So part of the patch, if you want to get the patch, it's going to print out on the back or on a second page, is the survey. So the survey is asking, what did you complete? What was your favorite thing about earning the patch? What did the girls learn about investing while earning this patch? What could make this patch better? We want your feedback. And then some questions about, do you feel comfortable setting goals for your future? You don't give up when things are hard. Do you agree with that? Even if I'm afraid of making mistakes, I still try new things. Girls like me can do important things. And girls like me can be good at many different things. And then if you are a Fidelity employee and you happen to watch this, or if you're watching right now, please reach out, please share this. And we want to get this information out. So I want to give a minute for anyone to ask questions, maybe share ideas about something you've heard me talk about. Maybe you want to see what the patch looks like again. Brittany did add the link on there. So click that link, scroll down to the Fidelity Investment, the Let It Grow Investment Patch Program. It's quite a good size patch. And we're really excited to provide this opportunity, especially as we've got a pause in some of our financial literacy growth right now because of the not being able to do booths. But this is a good way to talk about some financial literacy while you're at home, how you can invest in yourself, invest in others, learn about businesses, learn about how we're all supporting each other and how you can be financially stable. Yeah, I'll show you that. So it's not in color. It is printed in black and white, and I apologize for that. But this is, so you get the first patch, this big one, and then all the consecutive patches are earned after that. And there's a flower on there, and it grows. You can see it kind of growing on there. My camera's flipped, and so things are reversed for me, and I apologize for that. But so the order form and everything you need is on there. Does anybody have any questions? Let me see, I might give. Now, one of the things, my favorite, the investing in home is a patch that I definitely want to work on. And one of the exciting things that you can do in step one, explore how different features in your house affect the price. So look at your neighborhood. So I love the Zillow app, Zillow. I can look and see what some of the houses sold for, if there's any houses for sale in my area, even pictures inside. Sometimes that's just fun to do. Now, even though you can't visit open houses right now to look at homes and complete this step of the investing in home patch, you can do open houses online. A lot of realtors across the U.S. are doing virtual opportunities right now. So jump in on a live of an open house, or watch the videos that they've been posting. And then, even more fun, you can host a virtual viewing party. So what's a show? I love there's a tiny home show on Netflix. And there's several shows out there of people buying homes or renovating homes. So maybe hop on a live chat, hop on Zoom or Facebook or Instagram or whichever platform you use, talk to your friends and the girls in your troop and watch a show together. So there are real estate and home improvement shows that show buyers searching for their perfect home. And you're going to see a difference in cost and where they're living and what features change the cost of the homes. So gather your friends to watch a few of these and see if you can predict how the different features offered will affect the price. Maybe you can predict before they give you the price of that show. And that could be, that's a fun activity and something you can do to make sure you have contact with each other, with your friends, with girls in your troop. So I appreciate you all so much. You all are doing amazing in interacting with us in these comments and joining us for these lives. We love them. And we're really enjoying being able to have this virtual touch. There is so much more to come. And as we've got the graphic, what's out now, there's going to be even more that we are sharing out coming forward. And we have ideas, and we're getting ideas from our teen girls and from our volunteers. And so if there are things that you want to see and things you want to share, please do that. Use the hashtag KY Girl Scouts at Home. You can reach Sarah and I by email, npoe@gswrc.org, and slewis@gswrc.org. Can seniors do, Meryl, you said, can seniors do, you mean all of them for this patch? So seniors can do the, seniors ambassadors can go back and do the ones for Daisy Brownie Juniors. They just keep in mind that they are going to be a little simpler. So you might want to spice it up a bit, girls. When you're looking at those and you're like, I don't want to draw a picture of this, what can you do? What can you do to increase that? We just wanted to make sure we gave an option for all ages, but every level can get all of these. For the younger girls who want to earn the older ones, maybe it's just a conversation with a parent or a guardian or a friend about how they know, what they know about investing in home, in college, and in retirement. Maybe they're talking to a grandparent or learning from someone. And it's, even if it's a conversation for those older girls, use your best judgment for that and what they're going to learn. All right. Again, thanks for handling and being patient with the technical difficulties as we started. We appreciate you so much. It's a beautiful day outside. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Thanks so much.